Today we'll be deriving the time of light. So the formula for the time of light, if we recall from the equation of motion, we have v to be equal to u plus at, right? Right, then we know that at maximum height v is equal to zero, then the component of u along this vertical component is u sine theta, because when we have u y then we have u x, so here we have u. So when we do this component, where is, here is u y and then here is u x, so sine theta becomes u y over u, so u y will not be equal to u sine theta. We know that acceleration along this component when the object is thrown up is minus g, and the time of light, that means the time it takes for the object to move up and down, that means when you throw an object from this point, it moves up to the maximum height, then it comes down. So the time of light is twice t, therefore the time of light is equal to 2 times t. So if you look now, since the final velocity is equal to zero, right, zero equal to u y minus g t, so it means g t is the same thing as u y. So when we make t the subject, we have t is equal to u y over g. So now if you recall from the resolution, u y is the same thing as u sine theta, so t is the same thing as u sine theta over g. So now if you recall that the time of light is the same thing as what, twice t, so time of light will not be equal to 2 u sine theta over what, over g. So now this is the equation for the time of light. So when you look, we have the equation of first equation of motion. We know that at maximum height the final velocity equals to zero, because when you launch the object from this point, it reaches a point. If this is a ball and you throw the ball up, it reaches a point whereby v is equal to zero, and when it comes down, then u is equal to zero, then v is greater than zero. So when it's so that's the reason why the final velocity equals to zero. And when you look at resolve, because we are dealing with the initial component of the velocity around this vertical component, that's the reason why we have u sine theta, and a is equals to minus g, because the object is moving in an opposite direction towards gravity, and that's how we have the time of flight. Thank you.